Alright folks, here we are. Gonna put the metal on the back today. The first thing you want to do is make sure all your wires are exposed here, just so you don't forget them and so they're not gonna get pinched behind anything. I've got mine all stapled down so they stay where they're supposed to be. So we've got all those ready to go. Made little cuts in the Unison vapor barrier. And we have to start by bringing the top down all the way. Okay, we're going to seal this up first on both sides because we start from here. Okay, so we got to get that down. So we're going to do that now. Remember, you want to do a few on this side. And then a few on the other side. Work your way back and forth. And what we want to do is where this seam, which is where our first piece of metal ties up into, where this bends around, you want to get that out a little flatter. And you don't want to tear it too much. We're going to go back later. If we do tear it a little bit, we'll fix it with liquid weld, a JB weld. So I want to flatten this out, pull this out this way a little bit to make it easier to get the metal up in there, and do the same on the other side when we get there. I got to grab another tool. Okay, what I needed was my needle nose. I grabbed the gas pliers instead. So we want to pull that out gently. Okay, and then we've got to separate it a bit because this is an S fold, okay? We want to get the metal up in between there into that S. So, as you can see there, I'm going to separate it like that so that we can get the new piece of metal up in there. There, see? I want to flatten out the other metal it's going up against here. So, you want to clean all this up and get it ready. As you can see there, we can slip the metal up in there. We can fold it over a little bit and slip it up in there. And then after we cut it, which you'll see us doing later on, then we can beat it over so that we have this half-inch lip, half-inch to 5/8 lip folded over. Which, remember, this trailer did not have before. If you remember, the metal just came right up and butted each other, and then we had that corner molding going down here. And right here is where the water gets in. It's like a big funnel. It's amazing to me that nobody figured this out at the shop at Shasta when they were building these, that would just be like a big funnel to direct water directly down to this corner, which is what rotted all the corners in this trailer. Maybe they just didn't expect them to be used much or for very long and didn't care. I don't know. But it wasn't very good thinking on Shasta's part way back then. So that's why we're replacing this metal. That's the whole reason. Remember, there was nothing wrong with the metal other than the fact that it wasn't wide enough to fold over the side. So it's the only reason we're replacing it. And it should be done on all these Shastas. If you tear this thing apart, don't put it back together the way they did because it'll leak. All right, we're gonna go to the other side and do the same thing, get it ready. The other thing, before we get to the other side, the other thing you wanna do is, I just realized that they did this. They put putty tape up in here, in this S-fold, which is unnecessary. That's why we have the S-fold. So they went to all the trouble to put putty tape up in here at a place that it's impossible for it to leak, unless you turn the trailer upside down and travel like that for 50 years. And even then it wouldn't leak. But they went to all the trouble to put putty tape up in here so it wouldn't leak, but they left this corner open like a giant funnel with that corner mold. So you want to get all this stuff out of here. Let's open that up a little bit. That's another good idea, is just open this seam up just a little bit, just a little bit. Not much, just enough to make it easy to slip the new metal under there. Remember that they used 019 thick metal, and we're using 025 thick metal. So I want to open it up just a bit to make it easier. Get all this putty tape out of here, if there's any in here. Oops. Then we can go to the other side. You know, I just want to show you how I've got that opened up. You can even cut it right here so that this stays down, but this part folds open. It looks to me like that's what they did, because I didn't cut that, and both sides are like that. So, new little trick that I just learned from Shasta. How about that? So, some things they did really well, and other things they did really crappy. Don't ask me why. All right, so what our goal is here, our goal is to end up with our bottom sheet starting right here and wrapping down to the bottom. So we want our side pieces to end right here with the top of the S-fold right there, so that when we put our bottom sheet up in here, it covers up here to the edge of the window, starts here and goes down. So we want to cut these two pieces on either side of the window to stop with the S-fold right there. Now what we want to do is we want to go from the edge of the window here out to, oh, like a half inch past the side here. But I usually cut it oversize, because that way you always have enough metal. If you cut it two size, you may run off a little bit, and if you run off a little bit, then you lose your fold over edge. So I'm going to make it like, you know, a couple inches too big, and then that way we can cut off the excess, because we have plenty of metal here. This thing, this is the piece we're using for the back, and we only need two pieces out of it, so I've really got more than twice as much metal as I need here. So I'm going to make it just a little oversized, maybe an inch and a half hangover, and then we can recut it once it's attached to the frame. 22 inches, so we're going to go 22 and a half. Here it's 22 inches also. So well, I don't think it runs off at all, does it? No, it doesn't run off at all here. Okay, so I'm going to make an executive decision here. I'm just going to make it 23 and a half. That way we're an inch and a half over, and we'll end up cutting an inch off this side if need be. I want to go 23 and a half. Notice we're cutting from the back side, just like we do with wood. Same way. See how that curls it up out of the way? I'm having a little hard time with this thing getting it going, but it's just because of the curvature of the metal and everything. But once you get it going, it works pretty well. Now we'll finish the cut. I just centered a line right down the middle of it. We'll finish the cut with these things. Measure down 13 and 7/8 from the top of the S-fold, which the top of the S-fold, the inside of it, right there. So 13 and 7/8. Basically, almost to this line right here. So we're going to cut just on that side of that line. That should work out just fine. I'm going to use these to cut this. I don't want this piece. I don't want that eighth or quarter inch curly Q material to come out because it won't be an exact measurement then. It's hard to do, so I'm just going to go ahead and cut this with these shears. A little harder to do. Right about to maybe start getting in here, and scissors gets in its own way, but if you're patient, it can be done. Yeah, it's not turning out to be that hard, so. Right along that line, cut the line off. It's actually easier than the electric shears. All right, so there's that piece. Go ahead and slip it up in there and see how it looks. I've already tested the window in this hole, so I know the hole's right here, so I'm just going to put it right where the wood is. I'm going to be ending up taking a little bit off of there, off this side. For some reason it overlaps the wood a little bit. That goes up in there like that. There's our first piece of metal and how that works. Before I tack this new piece in, I want to bring this down and tack it in place. So we'll just put a tack in it a little bit. Actually, I need shorter staples for that. All right, so we'll go ahead and staple this down now. I just want to show you close up here where you staple. Of course, we have a piece of wood going along here, and the same at the top, and we stapled this one down previously before I installed this piece. I don't know if I showed you that, but that's what we did. And it's this bottom lip here that's underneath the S-fold. Of course, see, this will be hidden. When we put the metal up in here into the S-fold, that'll hide this. So the bottom of these is where you nail. So anywhere that you have a seam like this, of course, you're going to need a piece of wood, a slat, running the entire length, whether it's on the wall on the side here, see where that seam is, or if it's in the back, you'll need a piece of wood there. So that's actually something to think about when you're framing. So glad I was able to tell you about that now. But they usually put the seams right in the front and the back right along the bottom of the window, so there is framing there. But on the sides, if you're doing any framing in there, remember that you need a piece of wood under there all the way down also for that seam there to be stapled to, because it's a hidden type thing. You staple the bottom and then hook the top of the next sheet into it, and it holds both down. So now we're ready to go ahead and apply our next sheet, which will cover the rest of the back of the trailer.